Okay, as we all know, when we have a right triangle like this, we can talk about the famous Pythagorean theorem, namely a squared plus b squared is equal to c squared. And yes, that's what we are going to do in this video. I will show you guys the proof that I like the most. Although there are a lot of proofs out there, at least hundreds of them, but I will just show you guys the one I like the most, alright? And I will also show you guys the inverse version of the Pythagorean theorem. So if you guys don't know what that is, be sure you guys watch till the end. First of all, let's take a look at this picture. If you look at B as your base, then A will be your height. If you look at A as your base, then B will be your height. If you look at C as your base, then the height will be just going from here, perpendicular down here. And I will just call that to be H. And when we do that, in fact, we get 1, 2, 3. Three right triangles, right? So I'm going to draw them out for you guys, but first let me call this to be C1 and this right here to be C2. And of course, C1 plus C2 will be the whole C. And let me just draw the smallest triangle right here first, and C1 will be the smallest side. So let me just put that down right here for you guys. So C1 and this right here will be H, right? So let me label C1 and H. And in this case, A is actually the hypotenuse of the smallest triangle. So this is the first one that we have. And for the second one, which is right here, H is actually the smallest side, and I'll put it down on the side here. And C2, it's going to be the median size side, which is right here. And of course, here is the right angle. And B is actually the hypotenuse. So I will just put that down right here. And I'll also put down the original for you guys. So this is the biggest one, and is that one, namely A, B, and C, like that. First of all these three triangles are similar. Why? Because angle. So you can look at here, you have this angle in the smallest triangle is right here, right? This angle is the same as that. And of course, it's the same angle right here. And both of these two triangles, they have 90 degree angles. So angle, the third angle will be the same as well. Similarly, for the second one, this angle is right here. And for the big one, you have this angle. So they are all similar. Right? This is similar to that. This is similar to that. Of course, this and that are similar as well by transitivity. So they are all similar. And with that being said, we can actually set up proportions to take care of some business. First, I'm going to compare the smallest triangle here and the biggest one, namely the original one right here. And I'm going to set proportions, but I don't want to involve H. So to do that, you see, for the smallest one, I have this and that. And I just have to say, OK, let's look at A over C1. This right here has to be the same as C over A, right? Hypotenuse to this, hypotenuse to that. So this right here is the first equation that we have. And you can, of course, cross multiply. And you get A squared. And this times that is just C times C1. So that's it. Now, for the second and the biggest one, still the same. I'll compare this and compare that. I want to set up a proportion, but I don't want H at all. So I'll be looking at this and that, this and that. So I will have B over C2. That should be equal to C over B. And of course, let's cross multiply. We get B squared equals C times C2. So C2 right here. So that's cool. And what we are going to do next is, well, this is equation 1. This is equation 2. I'm just going to add them up. I'll just say 1 plus 2. It's not 3. Okay? Equation 1 plus equation 2. On the left-hand side, I have A squared. On the left-hand side right here, I have B squared. So of course, we get A squared plus B squared. And for the right-hand side, here we have C1. Here we have C2. Notice that they both have a C, so I can factor that out. So I get C1 plus C2, like this. And now, if you look at what's C1 plus C2. Well, of course, if you look back, C1 plus C2 is the whole C, the original C. So in another word, we get A squared plus B squared equals this C times another C. And of course, this is A squared plus B squared equals C squared. Ta-da! This right here is it. I like this proof so much because, to be honest, I don't like to draw that big triangle and cut this triangle, I mean big rectangle and cut that into like four right triangle, all that stuff. I think this is easier for me to draw and demonstrate, in my opinion. And it can also practice the similar triangle business. All right, anyway, in fact, this picture is also really cool because we can also talk about the inverse Pythagorean theorem. So let me draw that again right here for you guys. Now, this time, we are going to talk about area. Again, when we have this right here, if you take B as your base, then A will be your height. So we can talk about the area right here. The area of this triangle, of course, is just 1/2 base times height. And let me just put down A times B right here. No problem at all. But if you look at C as your base, well, the height will be, you go from here to here, and just like that, I will call this to be H. Well, of course, we're talking about the same right triangle. The areas have to be the same. You'll just have the same area. This has to be the same as 1/2 base times height. So C times H. And now we have this equation. Right here, we can multiply both sides by 2 so that 1/2 will be gone. And we'll just look at this as AB equals CH. This time, I don't want to end up with any C's. Earlier, we have the C. This time, we don't have the C. Earlier, I didn't involve the H. This time, we will get the H. So to do that, I'm going to divide both sides by H, right? So if you do that, you get AB over H equals C. And why do we want to do that? Because now we have that, so we must have A squared plus B squared equals C squared. And what's our C now? Namely, AB over H. So in other words, this equation is the same as A squared plus B squared equals AB over H, and we square that. Well, we can do some algebra real quick. This is just A squared plus B squared equals, you can just put the powers right here, A squared, B squared over H squared. That's just all multiplying and dividing. And I'm going to divide everybody by A squared and B squared. So let me just show you guys the work by putting this down in the front, multiplied by 1 over A squared B squared. When you do this times that, you get the A squared cancel, and you have the B squared in the denominator, so we get 1 over B squared. Similarly, when you do this times that, the B squared will cancel this time, and we get 1 over A squared, and that will be equal to this and that. Well, they will cancel out. We just have the H squared in the denominator, like this. And ladies and gentlemen, let me put this down right here for you guys, right here. I will write down 1 over A squared first, and I'll put that down as A to the negative 2 power. And then I'll write this down as plus B to the negative 2 power. And of course, I will put this down as this is equal to H to the negative 2 power. And this right here, it's the inverse Pythagorean theorem.